So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special riddle now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
I always wondered what became of him.
You know this dragon?
Yes, although he wasn't a dragon when I knew him.
What do you mean? What was he?
Dwarf. A greedy little bugger.
Not so little anymore.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads?
Tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad.
You were taken from this realm too early.
Good. The special chisel is ahead past this gate.
Watch out! You who walks among the living. My beloved Gulvig calls to me.
What?
Gulvig, say the...
Really?
Boy.
I can smell...
Boy.
They've taken three of sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Three of her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
look
while
if
we...
you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, the quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son. But in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh, no. You found the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty claw bag just got lucky.
A wolver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Tip of one, yes. A very, very giant chisel.
That big crystal on the giant's ring looks promising. Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Trick, lad.
His idea.
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
It's magically locked.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Hostiles up ahead. I'm ready if you are.
Get off of me! Make it free! Atreus, follow me.
Be right there. Hey, Harden World Tree Sap. That's handy.
Read it.
To Njord, we offer back the sea's bounty.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
What's that up there?
Ha! gunshot.
How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Right.
Wow, that was, something, that, fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good apple.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there meat on his breath?
Huh?
You let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now, shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go.
So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around.
I
here.
Know of a place
correct.
That may contain some
but how do we move forward?
Treasure.
His beard with it.
I happen to think he looks dashing. You know, for a snow-covered corpse.
Right here!
We heading into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the chisel tip?
No.
I'll keep thinking.